Education, Mr. Jadron Chai Sang, on the stage to deliver his keynote and opening speeches. Please, sir.
Associate Professor Dr. Vithya Dina Dechakul, Director of Southeast Asian UNICEF Education Organization, Secretariat. Professor Dr. Vasilios E. F. Tinakis, President of World IDAC Association. Ms. Jaruwan Suvarnasad, Mr. Chandro Lim Kitisi, Managing Director of Reed FedEx Company, exhibitors, supporting associations, members of the press, ladies and gentlemen. It is my great pleasure and honor to have been invited to open this forum and share my perspective on Southeast Asia education, working together for a sustainable future. I admire the joint collaboration between CIMEO, UNESCO, World IDAC, and the Reed FedEx Company. Congratulate them on their success in bringing educations together from many countries around the world. This is very encouraging for the education community in Thailand and ASEAN. Thailand has been quite successful in providing educational access for all, and Thai literacy rates generally been high. Nevertheless, criticisms of the Thai education system have been increasing in recent years. Too many effort is still being made to memorize large chunks of information. Rote learning has been the cornerstone of education for too long. Thai students are not taught to think critically. They spend too much time rote learning in the classroom and end up with poor analytical skills. Most Thai teachers still use teacher-centered modes of information dissemination. These are, of course, generalizations. We also hear of Thai student success in various educational and academic competitions, of scholastic achievements, and examples of teaching excellence. But they are the exceptions. This is the case in Thailand. I believe that several countries in Southeast Asia can relate to it. For Thailand, the need for change and to redefine education imperatives has been accepted. And a major reform program is in the process of being implemented. The Thai government is committed to major education reform. It is now focused on improving Thai students' performance and achievements in key subject areas measured by the program for International Student Assessment, or PISA. Specifically, the whole learning system, from curriculum to teaching learning, along with assessment and evaluation, will be reformed. The purpose of this major reform is to improve students' critical thinking ability, self-learning, and problem-solving skills. The current system of teacher training and development also be reviewed and improved to ensure that there are sufficient numbers of suitably qualified Thai teachers. Teachers will be assessed and promoted in line with their successes in improving students' performance and achievements. I intend to promote, I should say, the Ministry of Education tends to promote increased involvement private sector employers industry groups and to encourage private sector entities to assume greater responsibilities in supporting and conducting educational programs. Hereby, I would like to respond to the president of the DIDAC statement that we welcome and look forward to the cooperation with World DIDAC on curriculum reform, the reform of education for educators. We will work closely together in that area. The Thai government is also committed to raise the quality of vocational education to an international standard consistent with the needs of the country. This will involve using a vocational qualifications framework to establish the skills, knowledge, and capabilities needed by employers. To improve the standards of technical and vocational education, further development of a dual education system will be encouraged. This requires increased involvement and participation by the private sector and industry groups at all stages of technical and vocational education and training. Workplace experience and formal classroom instruction will be focused. Ultimately, it is hoped to raise the proportion of learners in vocational and general education streams to a ratio of 50-50. Higher education institutions will be encouraged to emphasize quality rather than quantity development. The government is strongly committed to supporting Thai universities to become more internationally recognized. With an aspiration to improve the ranking of Thai universities, university rankings will also be used as a guide in developing the quality and standards of Thai universities compared to acknowledged world-class universities. Such improvement will include encouraging Thai universities to undertake research, innovation, technology through mechanisms such as performance-based budget allocation. Ensuring 21st century competitiveness and skills for all may mean different things for developing and developed countries in the Southeast Asian region. The integration of the ASEAN community in 2015 has encouraged its member states to learn about each other's languages and cultures. English has also become its official language. This is inconsistent with the growing global connectivity that is forcing countries to improve their citizens' English language skills. Language skills, together with digital literacy and critical thinking skills, are widely recognized among the basic competencies needed in the 21st century. They can increase access to new information as the foundations of knowledge building, innovation, and economic diversification. They also enhance social, academic, and occupational mobility. This thus another important priority for education in Thailand is the expansion of ICTs in education and the wider teaching of languages, particularly English and Mandarin Chinese. Distinguished guests, ladies and gentlemen, the integration of the ASEAN community in 2015 will enhance cooperation in all three pillars, comprising ASEAN economic community, ASEAN political security community, and ASEAN socio-cultural community. These three pillars have been identified with implications for the field of education and with the recognition of education's role in narrowing the development gap among ASEAN member states. Thailand's Ministry of Education strongly supports ASEAN's priorities for education, as documented in the ASEAN Socio-Cultural Community, ASCC. blueprint, and the ASEAN 5-year work plan on education. Apart from building the ASEAN identity, most of the priorities in the ASCC blueprint are consistent with targets reflected in the Millennium Development Goals, including human development, social welfare and protection, social justice and rights, narrowing development gaps, and ensuring environmental sustainability. These priorities are included in the ASEAN 5-year Work Plan on Education, 2011 to 2015, which addresses the awareness of regional identity, the importance of universal access to high-quality basic education, the need for technical and vocational education and training, TVET, to be responsive to economic needs and for higher education to deliver world-class instructional programs and research. Thailand appreciates the contribution of the ASEAN University Network, AUN, and the Southeast Asian Ministers of Education Organization, CBO, to cross-border mobility and internationalization of education. The role of the AUN in establishing an AUN quality assurance process and the AUN ASEAN credit transfer system has been well recognized. On the other hand, we also appreciate CMEO's initiatives in priorities for education, such as 21st century skills, professional development for teachers and educational personnel, education for all, education for sustainable development, higher education and TVET. Nevertheless, I would like to encourage CMEO and ASEAN to work more vigorously in establishing an ASEAN qualification reference framework to address academic and professional accreditation standards across the ASEAN region. Such a framework will help support credit transfers and the mutual recognition, integration, and harmonization of qualifications in both vocational and higher education sectors, as well as promote student worker mobility across participating ASEAN countries. So far, collaboration in the ASEAN education sector has focused more on higher education rather than on TVET. However, TVET is an area of particular concern since the economies of many ASEAN member states have expanded rapidly and continuously amidst their shortages of skilled workers. Personally, I admire the fact that ASEAN's cooperation with other participating countries in the East Asia Summit, as reflected in the EAS Education Plan for Action 2012 to 2015, has been inclined to facilitate regional cooperation in TVET. This plan of action was adopted with priorities to develop a regional TVET quality assurance framework to facilitate TVET teachers and student mobility, and to conduct a feasibility study to establish a register of TVET providers in the EAS. I would also like to draw your attention to the ASEAN Environmental Education Action Plan 2008-2012, which reflected ASEAN's contribution to the UN Decade of Education for Sustainable Development. Amongst other goals, the ASEAN Curriculum Sourcebook also addresses the themes of connecting global diversity and local identity, as well as working together for a sustainable future. In Thailand, as many other parts of the world, we live in challenging times. In the field of education, this is particularly the case. We are approaching the end of an era, the target date for achieving the Millennium Development Goals in 2015. the end of UN Decade of Education for Sustainable Development in 2014. The ASEAN community will progress to a new level of integration in 2015. And the EFA movement launched by UNESCO in 1990 is now almost 25 years old. Increasingly, educators are turning to the next era of education, whether it is described as education post 2015, education for 21st century skills, education for a sustainable future, or in some other way. Whatever the terminology, we can be reasonably sure that globalization trends will become more pronounced and will greatly impact the future of education. Indeed, they already do. Globalization is a phenomenon that needs to be addressed because it has changed the way we live. I regard challenge positively and believe that we can no longer effort to live as isolated nations or regional communities. We cannot ignore the inhabitants of other parts of this planet and their problems. Actions and decisions of ordinary citizens are today more likely to affect others across the globe than ever before. A challenge across much of the ASEAN region, including Thailand, is that of replacing traditional instruction in schools, which tend to educate students and to process them into roles for economic production. Schools have traditionally processed students through stratified steps leading to predictable, marketable credentials for marketplace rather than for broader citizenship and social responsibilities. Education must fully assume its central role in helping people to forge more just, peaceful, tolerant, and inclusive societies. It must give people the understanding, skills, and values they need to cooperate in resolving the interconnected challenges of the 21st century. International developments, as aforementioned, have several common themes. The dominant theme is the need to prepare students to belong to a global community and for global citizenship. In order to achieve this goal, it is essential to ensure that teacher education adequately prepares teachers for their new roles and responsibilities. I think it is a crucial time to re-examine the social expectations of schools and teachers. Society anticipates that teachers and schools have the ability not only to prepare students for the workforce, but also to nurture them as global citizens. This is reflected in the trends and initiatives originating from the UN and UNESCO. The UN Secretary General's Global Education First Initiative stresses the need for a global perspective in education. Likewise, UNESCO's Teaching and Learning for Sustainable Future program promotes a new vision of education that helps students better understand the world in which they live and complexity and interconnectedness of transnational problems and issues. Distinguished guests, ladies and gentlemen, in terms of working together for a sustainable future, Thailand has always strongly supported regional and international bodies, including CIMEO and UNESCO. This will continue with the signing of a framework agreement for cooperation between ASEAN and UNESCO in November this year. Education has been and will always be a major part in any bilateral and international collaboration. There's no doubt that education is an essential mechanism in preparing our citizens not only for regional integration but also for a wider global context. The ultimate goal of education is to assist all learners to achieve their full potential, to be able to adapt to the multicultural society, and to cope with a world characterized by change. Education is of pivotal importance in shaping the world we live in, respect for others and the environment. In offering this perspective, Minister of Education of Thailand invites collaboration with all countries and international agencies. We are very happy to share our experiences in detail and learn from the successes of others. Once again, I would like to extend my appreciation to Green Tradex Company for organizing this forum. On behalf of the Thai government, I would like to welcome you all and wish you every success in your deliberations. With these remarks, I now declare this forum officially opened. Thank you very much.
Thank you, sir. Ladies and gentlemen, it's now time for the ribbon cutting ceremony, and I would like to invite Mr. and Mrs. Co-Chairpersons on the stage for the ceremony that will mark the official opening of World Dai Dai Asia 2013. And